Now, I'm going to show you the solution to the search problem rather than try to make you do it yourself, because it's still a few tricks here that are different from the previous search problem. So I'm going to define bridge problem, which takes a sequence of elements here. And if you want, you can pass in a frozen set of 1, 2, 5, 10 or whatever. But if you didn't, I'm going to go ahead and do that conversion for you. I'm going to make it into a frozen set, and I'm going to add in the light in case you forgot to specify that. So you can just ask bridge problem of the list 1, 2, 5, 10. I'll take care of it all for you. Like before, the explored set starts off being the empty set. The frontier starts off being the one initial state, which is the frozen set we've just made up for the everything that's on the here side, an empty set for everything that's on the there side, and zero for the elapsed time. And the idea is to get everybody away from here onto the other side. And so if we were given a trivial problem where there was already nobody here, then we're done and we return that initial state. Otherwise, just like before, we start popping things off the frontier. Just like before, we're looking at our successors. And the only difference is down here. Whereas before, we put a path on the end and we were expanding out our frontier and taking off the shortest path first from our frontier. Because in the previous problem, in the water pouring problem, the best solution was defined as the solution that was shortest with the smallest number of steps. In this problem, the best solution is defined as the one with the smallest elapsed time, where the elapsed time of a path is the second element, that's the t element here, of the final element of the path. That would be the total elapsed time of a path. And so we sort the frontier by the total elapsed time. Now, it is a little bit wasteful here that we're going through this loop. We only added in one new element and we sorted the whole thing. Python's actually pretty good at that type of sort. There are other ways to make that more efficient, but just conceptually, that's what we're doing. We always want to have the frontier sorted so that we're taking the fastest time first. So I typed that program in and I ran it for the very first time. Bridge problem 1, 2, 5, 10. I got an answer back. And remember, the answer is a path, which is an alternation of states and actions. We can pick out just the actions like this by asking for the path and then taking a slice of that path, starting at element number one, going to the end, and giving us every other element. So that'll be just the actions. And those are these three actions. That's my proposed solution that my program came up with. And my question is that correct? Yes or no?